held on the 20th February 2013. And it's 229 pages 175-176. Change of the scheme of delegation to offices for the definition of application. Planning related matters. We have a proposer and seconder. Proposer and seconder?
Taken to the committee on the 23rd of January. is 13 votes to 0, 13 votes to 0, to approve the changes that we made on a motion that was moved by the Chair, seconded by Councillor David Allison on behalf of the Conservative Committee, and supported by me. The Conservative Amendment tonight raises issues of the professional involvement of a member, and I'd emphasise that. Professional involvement of a member. A member is entitled to conduct a business and conduct it professionally. And if that isn't the case, then there are regular recourse to very standard committee and board. I do take very strong objection, however, to the Conservatives attempting to wrap up in this amendment some issue around private involvement of members. There is no change whatsoever to a member's private planning business being brought to the planning committee, and it is inclined to suggest otherwise. The new clause in the scheme of delegation, Mr. Mayor, allows for one objection only to trigger a process that begins with the planning application that will have been submitted by a member of professional capacity, to then be highlighted to the group spokespeople who can consult more widely. That compares, Mr. Mayor, with the scheme so that it involves either any other member of the public, which required 25 people to object before the thing is brought to the attention of members. So there is an onerous.
Would you like to try the microphone now? I might have been
corrected. Yes, Mr. Mayor. The scheme of delegation caused them allows 25 people to object. The situation so far as the professional involvement of a member only allows one person. So one person objected, their neighbour, somebody over the road, would trigger a transparent process in terms of political involvement. Mr. Mayor, the terms of neighbour notification have not altered. The terms of the notification to members in the wards have not altered, and the terms of the ability of an individual member to take a matter out of delegation has also not altered. Councillors Hodson and Rowlands may have been able to move over Councillor Allerton and the rest of the planning, Conservative planning members on that committee, which I think is a shame, because I will tell Councillors Hodson and Rowlands. But in my view, independently and on a non-party political plan, I think they do an excellent job of scrutinising planning applications and take their role seriously, which they have done on this matter, and made recommendations for the planning committee in support of these things. And I think it is a shame that party political movement by the Conservative Party to attempt to create some illusion of unprobity within the planning system, which is one of the best in the Northwest.
Thank you, Mr. Members will know that I'm a deputy of my group on the planning committee, but I do attend the planning committee frequently, sitting in the public area to represent my constituents. Now, when I first saw this set of amendments, I thought they were eminently sensible, just as described by Councillor Kelly. All the boxes seemed to be ticked, all the safeguards seemed to be there. I even spoke to the member, I think you referred to the state of, I think that's fair enough, that's been sorted out for you now. But having reflected on what other more experienced members have said to me, I came to the conclusion they were absolutely right, that this is a matter of perception, purely perception, and we must not be perceived with the slightest chance of anything being swept under the carpet. And that, by supporting this amendment, that is what we would do. Let us not give the slightest chance. Mr. Mayor, we all get a big brown envelope through our letterbox every Friday evening.
My pocket's full.
Absolutely. Members of the public have said to me, oh, well, of course, you know, they saw you all right on that, didn't they? Well, no, Mr. Mayor, they did not. But don't let them have the slightest chance they could possibly think that we did. Obviously, I have some difficulty with this, which
definitely not a party political issue. The scheme of delegation that was proposed, in fact, runs to about 4 or 5 pages, and there were 6 items that were subject to nominal amendment. This was one of the 6. And I need to read it to you just to avoid any ambiguity. And I think this endorses really what Councillor Kelly has said. You want to listen to the wording of this because it makes it clear what it actually meant. It's under section 8 of the recommendations, and it reads as follows, and I quote, any application where an elected member is involved in any capacity as an agent or consultant where at least one objection has been received, that must be underlined, where no objections have been received, the head of regeneration and planning assisted by the development manager may determine such application following consultation with and the agreement of the chair of the planning committee and the other party spokespersons. That's the end of it. That's what was stated. Now, what I'm concerned about, and I do understand what my colleagues have said, this was proposed initially by officers, not by members of the planning committee, as a way to try and make the planning process more efficient, both for themselves and for the planning committee, who quite often sit until quite late at night adjudicating some of these issues. And recently, quite a few of those applications have been for unelected members' applications. Some of them have been reported, some of them have been a bit of paving in the front garden or rear garden. And we've all considered it was really a waste of our time for officers to produce a detailed and lengthy report on those items, only for us to look at it, agree that it's not a problem, and vote it through. Now, that's the original perception. But having listened to what has been said both by my colleagues and by Councillor Kelly, of course, it is clear party spokesperson discussed and agreed these proposals, but on reflection, along with the issue raised by my colleague, what we're trying to avoid is any elected member at any time being seen to undermine the process, and it is essential that we all, it is a part of all of us in this room, it's necessary for us all to demonstrate probity and not be put in the position where we could not only be seen to have put something through on the side, but actually benefited from it. We cannot have that, and I think on reflection, it is necessary for us to have that degree of probity which ensures that none of us can be accused of passing something through at the back door, so to speak. If we do not take note of this objection, it could lead to accusations of members doing things to their benefit secretly behind closed doors. That was why I changed my mind on this particular issue. Not changed it dramatically, but one of the 6 issues that were up for delegation, the 5 were perfectly okay. But this one, on reflection, I do think we need to take care of the fact that we can never be put in a position that having slipped something through the back door because we get the press. Councillor Hodson has already mentioned a specific case where he did bring it to committee and he was still accused of doing something wrong. So as far as I'm concerned, transparency and probity must override what we try to do in this instance, trying to take this matter away from the committee consideration. Thank you for your
attention. Councillor Rowlands, second. Geoffrey?
Absolutely.
No, just to follow up. Councillor Rowlands, Chair, just would like to reply.
Ah, right. Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Let's try and be fairly straightforward about this. I mean, again, this is, as Councillor Ellison pointed out, there are a series of recommendations that came forward. And this particular one, again, it certainly had concerns for me. And I think primarily it's a concern for colleagues, actually. And making sure, as others have said, that not only are people doing the right thing, but being seen to do the right thing. And I actually think experience would suggest, I think our members, our planning committee do a fantastic job in really difficult circumstances and act in a very open, transparent way, actually. And quite often you see voters go in and think people tend not to vote across the party lines and vote across and so on. And I think that's good, and I think the public should have a lot of confidence in the way the planning committee operates, and I would certainly agree this much with Stuart in terms of what a great job the members of the planning committee do. way of doing things. But I just think, well, for all of our sakes, I think it's worth making sure that that a protection to our reputation is in place. And this is certainly not a party thing. It is, in fact, a reputation thing to make sure that we all maintain our reputation. I think that would be the point that we make. We need to, as I say, not just put our eyes in the rear view mirror, but physically be seen to do so.
Mr. Mayor, having in the past been in the forefront of the planning application dispute hitting the front pages of all local newspapers, I was relieved that when it was resolved, I as a councillor was able to do this in front of the planning committee. When it was seen to be being corrected at the board with openness and transparency, leaving the public, officers and fellow members with no doubt that no shortcuts or favouritism has been shown. Whilst I agree the applications to planning should be dealt with as efficiently and as speedily as possible, care should be taken that when councillors or council officers is the applicant, a greater level of transparency is required. Mr. Mayor, recent changes to planning legislation have already put the objectors to a planning application at a disadvantage in favour of applicants. Those changes were widely regarded by the public as changing the level playing field and were received with suspicion. I feel that the proposed changes to the delegation to officers for determination could, in my view, leave open challenges under the Freedom of Information Act with regards to officer or council planning applications. Having just accepted in full the recommendations from the independent inspections this council has been through, in which transparency, openness, and public participation was highly recommended as a way forward for this council, this proposal does not sit well with those recommendations we all signed up to. Mr. Mayor, I feel that the changes that Minute 299, if voted through tonight, will erode the transparency and trust we have all adopted and accepted in this council, and therefore ask that this council refer these changes back for further consideration. Furthermore, that members of this council who are involved in a planning application, professionally or private, should be scrutinised by a full planning committee. I second the motion.
Councillor Mooney, you have the right to reply.
Thank you all for your comments, and thank you, Stuart, for all the past things and dates. So well. Firstly, the scheme of delegation, the suggested changes have been brought to bring us in line with all the other law policies. The scheme was debated by the planning committee, and debated at length by the planning committee. A number of suggestions were put forward. A meeting was then held by the spokespeople. We sat down and we discussed a number of issues, and a number of issues were taken into account. We then took it back to the planning committee again when we sat down and we discussed it, and we voted on it, and it was unanimous in its decision. There is an option within the planning in the report that we can take any application out at any time. There's also the strengths and views that has been raised by most of the speakers as well, so it's only planning committee, about only needing more objections for things to grant. Between being able the option to take things out of the delegation and the things to take any application you want to at any time out of the delegation, and also the objections, any one objection, which is left to the planning committee, therefore to council, there's always an objection of some sort. So they will be discussed. That will strengthen, I think, the opportunity to scrutinise. The planning committee, I think, is one of the most seriously responsible committees that we have here. All our committees are responsible for the planning committee take a real responsibility about their commitment to ensuring that we uphold and we scrutinise everything that comes to us. I think the planning committee have made their decision. As chair, we moved it definitely and we voted on it. I don't agree. I think the planning commission has made right decision. And I think things will go forward, and things will always be scrutinised the way they should be, and we will be scrutinised everything. And as you say, if anybody's not happy with it, there is always you can go to the yes. There's always going to be people who can go back. I don't agree with this amendment. I ask people to vote against the amendment. The planning committee are taking the view very, very seriously, voting unanimously, and I'd like to say please vote to people to vote against the amendment. Thank you very much.
All those against? Clearly not. All those in favour of the recommendation contained within Minute 229, please clearly indicate. All those in favour? All those against? Thank you.